Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna. Having seen the description and divisions of Bharata-varsha into 9 islands, and specifically seeing the special qualities and characteristics of the 9th division, which is known as Bharata-varsha, Bharatakanda, Kaumarika Dvipa, and Navadvipa, etc., etc. Now, let us see how this Bharata-varsha, specifically the 9th division of Bharata-varsha, is seen by the Vedic literature and the Vedic seers. The depiction of Bharata-varsha, how does it look like? The depiction of Bharata-varsha, the map, how this Bharata-varsha looked like, was first discovered by Sri Thiruvenkata Ramanujajiyar, who was born in 1805, lived all the way up to 1882. Based on the shlokas of Mahabharata from Sri Bhishma Parva section, Jambu-kanda Vinirnaya Parva and 5th chapter, when we refer to Bhandarkar Oriental Research Institute, these shlokas were found in the 6th chapter. The shloka numbers are 12, 15, 16. Talks about the brief description about this Bharata-varsha. Sudarshanam pravakshami dvipam te kuru nandana parimandalo maharaja dvipo sau chakra samstita yatacha purusha pashet adarshe mukamatmana evam sudarshana dvipo drushate chandra mandale dviramshe pipalastatra dviramshe cha shasho mahan sarvaushadi samavapi sarvata paribhramita. Sri Thiruvenkata Ramanujayar, who actually was born in Thirumangalam, which is very close to Sri Perambudur, as he grew up, as he took up to the renounced order of life, he made his residence in Sri Perambudur, and then he widely travelled all over the land, length and breadth of India, preaching the glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This Sri Thiruvenkata Ramanujajiyar, while he was travelling through the area of Melkote, he was reading this section of Mahabharata from Sri Bhishma Parva Jambu Vinirnaya Kanda section. So while he was reading through, he came up these couple of these verses. So then he was pondering over what is the meaning of these verses, what to do with the geography of this place of Bharata-varsha in Mahabharata. Then he was pondered about all these things. Then he drew as per his understanding of those shlokas. This is another portrait can be seen in his mutt in Sri Perambudur. So wherein the explanation of these verses has given in Vedic Cosmology video. Sudarshanam pravakshami dvipam te kurunandana parimandalo maharaja dviposo chakra samsita. This Bharatakanda, Mahabharata calls this tract of land as Bharatakanda, is called Sudarshana Dvipa. Sudarshana Dvipa. Since it looks beautiful to the eyes of the onlookers, Sudarshanam, it is very wonderful to look at, that's why it is called a Sudarshana. Being circular, it looks like the disc of the Lord. Sudarshana Chakra, the preceding deity of Sudarshana Chakra is also Lord Sudarshanam, whose deity is always seen in a chakra. It is attached to the cyclic time in the form of disc, preceded by God Sudarshana. So basically it is mentioned here as this particular Bharata-varsha is connected with Satya, Treta, Dvapara, Kali, which is like a cyclic time period. Thus, Sudarshana Chakra is also kind of Kala Chakra. So thus, everything is kind of matching to each other. So this is Lord Sudarshana in his glorious form. Thus is Chakra, which is represented by this particular thing. This is Lord Sudarshana Chakra. So then, further, it is mentioned Parimandala. The meaning of Parimandala in Sanskrit text as a circle, sphere, gola, round, etc., etc. Sudarshana Dvipa is in the form of a globe, since all the four corners of this Bharatakanda is rounded like bale fruit. Here, the acharyas take the meaning of Parimandala to be globe, though Sanskrit is telling Parimandala to be circle, etc., etc. So, it is like a bale fruit, which is round in all four corners. is another globular object. Vriksha pushva palopetai sampanna dhana danyavan lavanena samudrena samantat parivartita. So it is mentioned here that this place is full of trees, covered with flowers and fruits, and with crops of various kinds, and with many other rich things. It is surrounded on all sides with salt ocean. Vriksha pushpa palopetai sampanna dana danyavan lavanena samudrena samantat parivartita. As you see from outside, this area looks as if this place, entire place, is covered with lot of flower bearing, food bearing trees, and the remaining area where there are no trees are seen is actually filled with water. The entire area occupied by trees is surrounded by water, which is salt water ocean. Yatacha purusha pashet pashet darshane mukam atmana evam sudarshana dvipo drushate chandra mandale. As a person can see his own face in a mirror, the nature of the sudarshana dvipa is viewed from the moon. Yatacha purusha pashet adarshe mukam atmana. Just like everyday morning we see our face in the mirror, similarly if we see this Sudarshan Dvipa, considering moon to be the mirror, then how it look like? That is what it is describing. Dviramshe pipalastatra dviramshe chasha shomahan sarvaushadi samavapai sarvata paribhrammita. Half of this Bharata-varsha appears like the rabbit and a small peepal leaf, sacred fig tree. Other half appears in the form of a big peepal leaf. They are surrounded by all varieties of vegetation. Dviramshe pipalastatra. Out of two parts, one part when it is seen from the moon, considering it to be mirror, it appears like a pipala tree leaves. Pipalastatra, sata pipala tree leaves. Dviramshe cha shashu mahan. On the other side, when you see, the other part of this Bharatakanda or Bharata-varsha appears to be like a great rabbit. Shesho means rabbit. Sarvaushadi samavapta, and these things are surrounded by different variety of aushadi or plants or leaves, etc. Sarvata paribrahmita, so like that, which are spread everywhere here and there. Apastato anya vigneya esha sankshepa uchate. The remaining area, apastato, the remaining area is situated with or filled with water. Beside these portions, the rest is all water. Thus, the depiction how it can look like as seen from moon is described in this set of verses of Mahabharata. Considering all these verses and their pondering over the meaning of these verses, Sri Thiruvenkata Ramanujiyar sketched a drawing of one big rabbit and peepal tree leaves as per the above Vedic hymn. That drawing eventually appeared like this, a big rabbit on one side and set of people leaves on the other side. They are drawn on a sheet of paper. Then he was pondering over what is the meaning of this drawing, what is the meaning of the description given in Mahabharata. He pondered over for a long time. Then he turned around. Then it came to his mind that, yeah, this is representing the world map of the tract of land on which we are living. The rabbit corresponds to Africa, Europe, Asia, etc., etc. And the people leaves on the left hand side represent the North and South American tract of land. The other areas are surrounded all over this area within the form of all kinds of vegetation. So thus, when this image is superimposed on the modern day world map, it appears to be like this. Almost similar to modern day world map. So thus we can see that, so this is the world map on the rectangular sheet, and the upper one is the world map on the circular globular shape. So thus the description which is given in Mahabharata has to do something with the place where we are living, which is known as Bharata-varsha, Bharatakanda, Kumarika Dvipa, Navadvipa, etc., etc., with different names in different Vedic literatures. So the same thing when it is seen in the entire Jambu-dvipa. This is the entire Jambu-dvipa in isometric view. It's in the center there is Mount Meru, and in the southern side there is Himalaya mountain, after following which there is entire Bharata-varsha, whose width is 9000 yojanas, which is divided by the ocean of salt water into 9 divisions, with each division of 1000 yojanas. The 9th division is explicitly described in the previous slides, and that is almost proved as if the earth sphere or earth globe on which we are residing, that is 1000 yojanas in width. So the actual portrait drawn by Sri Thiruvenkada Ramanujayar, which is still preserved in Melkote and Sri Perambudur, is seen in this slide. This is the entire picture drawn by Sri Thiruvenkada Ramanujayar, which shows all the different varieties of the entire this structure of Bhumandala and the universe. This is the entire universe, which is surrounded by 7 layers, and in this universe, this is the surface of the Bhumandala, wherein this is the section of Jambu-dvipa, which is divided into 9 parts. This is the Mount Meru, this is Dhruva Loka, and here is Earth Globe with the Bharata Varsha or Bharata Khanda, which is there. And its image is drawn here. A great Dviramshe Pippalastatra Dviramshe Shesho Mahan Sarvavshadi Samapta Paribrahmita. So it's like that. This is about this particular Earth Globe, how it look like. And these are the remaining islands and the remaining oceans, etc. This is Loka Loka Mountain, etc. And beneath this Bhumandala, there are 7 lower planets, beneath them Ashtadigajas, etc., etc. These are upper planet systems are shown here. And this is the chariot of the sun, in which it travels with single wheel and driven by Aruna, etc. These are the heavenly planets, talking about all the heavens, ultimately leading to Vaikuntha, the abode of the Lord Vishnu. And this is about the formation of the eclipse, Rahu Ketu movement, which causes the lunar and solar eclipses, etc. Thus, all the details are encapsulated in one drawing, which helps us to understand what and how the universe is functioning. About the same thing, let us see a small video.
Srila Prabhupada's desire for the diagram was not to go unfulfilled. That elusive map was discovered by Srila Prabhupada's disciples at the holy village of Melukote, some 50 kilometers north of Mysore, Karnataka, in India. This diagram accurately depicted the entire cosmology of Srimad Bhagavatam in an ingenious yet simple rendering. The person through whom it was revealed to the world was the 19th century scholar saint Thiruvenkata Ramanuja G.R. Swami. Born in Sri Perambudur, Tamil Nadu, Thiruvenkata Swami went on to become an acharya, or spiritual leader, in the preceptorial line known as the Sri Sampradaya. He spent several years of his life in Melukote, which 900 years earlier had been the residence place of Sripad Ramanujacharya, the most prominent acharya of the Sri Sampradaya. At Melukote, in the 1,000-year-old temple, Thiruvenkata Swami studied and taught the Vedas and also worshipped the deity of Tiru Cheluva Narayan. One day, while studying the Mahabharata, a 5,000-year-old epic of ancient India, he came across some intriguing verses. In the 5th chapter of Jambu Khanda, Bhishma Parva of Mahabharata, it is said,
Sudarshanam pravakshami dvipastu guru nandana parimandalo maharaja dvipoyam chakra samstita yato hi purusha pashyet darshanam mukham atmana evam sudarshana dvipo drishyate chandramandale dviramshe pippalastatra dviramshe cha saso mahan sarvaushadhi samavayais
This Bharat Khanda is called Sudarshana Dvipa, since it looks beautiful to the eyes of the onlookers. Being circular, it looks like the disc of the Lord, and it is attached to cyclic time in the form of a disc presided over by Lord Sudarshana. Bharat Khanda is in the form of a globe, since all of its four corners are rounded like the bale fruit. When viewed from the moon, half of Bharat Khanda appears like the rabbit and a small peepal leaf, while the other half appears in the form of a big peepal leaf, with all of them surrounded by varieties of vegetation. Pondering the verses, he became perplexed. What on earth can a rabbit and peepal leaves have to do with geography or cosmography? As he sought to understand their meaning, he contemplated, meditated, and prayed. Finally, by divine inspiration, he sketched a drawing of the rabbit and the peepal leaves, but still remained mystified about their connection with the Earth's geography. Suddenly it dawned on him that if the drawing was turned upside down, the rabbit perfectly corresponded with Europe, Asia, and Africa, while the peepal leaves corresponded with North America, South America, and Australia. These continents comprise our Earth, which the Mahabharata calls Bharat Khanda. Vishnu Purana also describes the earth as Bharat Khanda and gives its diameter as 8,000 miles. The earth is also referred to by the name Bharat Khanda in the invocation Sankalpa mantra chanted by Brahmana priests since time immemorial up until the present day.
Jambu-dvipe, Bharata-varshe, Bharata-khande, Meroho.
Vedic cosmology gives descriptions of the entire cosmos, including its subtle features. Perception and access to these subtle features, however, requires karmic qualification. Consequently, much of the cosmos described earlier, as well as parts of the cosmography about to be described, are imperceptible and inaccessible to us earthly inhabitants. Bharat Khanda is one of the nine islands of the larger and originally bow-shaped Bharata-varsha, which was divided by the sons of Sagara. Being completely surrounded by water, the islands are mutually unreachable. In the Vedas, Bharat Khanda, our earth, is also referred to by other names such as Sudarshan Dvip, Kumarika Dvip, and Navadvip, etc.
Now, let us see a few references about supporting this particular description of Mahabharata, whether is it okay or not okay, can be accepted or not. The reference from Suvasiddhanta from chapter 12, verse number 53 talks about Sarvatraiva Mahigole Swastana Swastana Muparisastam Manyate Ke Yato Golasya Kordvam Kwa Api Ada. This says that had the shape of earth is spherical, sarvatraiva mahi gole. People in each place think themselves to be uppermost. Mannate ke eto golasya ka urdvam kwa api adha. Sarvatraiva mahi gole swastana muparistitam. Everyone thinks that they are situated in the uppermost area. But the globe of earth is situated in ether. Mannate ke eto golasya, ke refers to outer space. What they need its upper and lower side. Ka urdham, ka adha. So this is what Surya Siddhanta indicated that. Indirectly it says that the earth play the tract of land on which we are living is Mahi Gole or Golasya. It is spherical in shape. So thus the descriptions in Mahabharata, which is taken as reference of Parimandala as spherical structure, and as it was shown in the video, and as see the references from Surya Siddhanta, there is some consistency there. So people, wherever they may stand, everyone thinks that they are on the upper part. They don't feel like low, even though it is in the lower surface of the earth globe. This is due to gravitational force. Then another reference from modern understanding of the measurements of the earth globe's diameter, etc. As per the scientific calculations, the mean diameter of the earth, which is the average diameter of the earth, entire earth, is 12,742 kilometers, and the diameter which is measured at the equator is 12,756.2 kilometers, and the diameter that is measured between the two poles, the north pole to south pole, is 12,713.6 kilometers. Approximately all the three numbers are closely matching, but with little bit differences. When we see the same thing from Srimad Bhagavatam, as per the descriptions mentioned in Vishnu Purana and Vayu Purana, Markandeya Purana, the ninth part of Bharata-varsha, the ninth island of Bharata-varsha, is considered to be earth globe, and its dimension is 1000 yojanas. Since the entire Bharata-varsha is 9000 yojanas, which is divided into 9 parts, each part would be around 1000 yojanas. When yojanas are converted into miles, wherein 1 yojana is equal to 8 miles, it becomes 8000 miles. And the same miles are converted into kilometers, wherein 1 mile is equal to 1.609 kilometers. That comes around 12,872 kilometers, which is more or less or approximately matching to the scientific number, which is the mean diameter is 12,742, 12,872. Most of the numbers which are mentioned in the Vedic literature are approximate number, and they are generally taken in terms of round figures. So in practical sense, there could be little differences, but as it's seen here, the close approximation indicates what we observe with our physical eye, with scientific observation we evaluate, are actually available in our Vedic literature with precision. We can understand with this details. And then Surya Siddhanta also talks about the diameter of the earth in another part of the Surya Siddhanta. The diameter of the earth globe is mentioned in Surya Siddhanta 16,000 yojanas, wherein the diameter is measured at the distance between the lower part of the lower part to the upper part of the surface along with its surface. So basically, the radius of the earth at a point on the surface is the distance from the center of the earth to the mean sea level at that point. So Surya Siddhanta says that the diameter is around 16,000 yojanas. How did they measure this diameter? The understanding of the measurement of diameter is, as you walk on the surface of the earth sphere, when you go from lower part of the earth sphere to the upper part of the earth, the distance covered by a person is considered to be the diameter of the earth globe. This is like practical measurement. So this, from geometric point of it, is equal to the half of the total circumference. Then for a sphere or a circle, the circumference is equal to 2 pi r, and the diameter is equal to circumference by pi, that is equal to 2 r. As per the measurements given here, as per the procedure of the measurement, the actual diameter of the earth globe, when we deduce through these calculations, actual diameter is equal to circumference by pi. The measurement given is half, equal to the half circumference, then total circumference is 1600 into 2 by pi. That comes around 1019 yojanas, which is as equal to the measure mentioned to this Bharata Varsha of its diameter as 1000 yojanas, 1000 to 1019 yojanas, like close approximation. So there's various references indicating to same number about the same place. Finally, we'll see some other references about this place from Srimad Bhagavatam. In 4th canto, it is mentioned as Sayekada imavato dakshineshu atasthanushu dadarsha navabirdvarbi puram lakshita lakshinam. This is while describing the allegorical story of Puranjanam. It is mentioned as, when Puranjana was travelling from place to place, looking after a place where he can experience complete happiness, that is where having traveled from different towns, he was not happy at all, since all the towns were not able to give him complete happiness. But when he came on the southern ridge of the Himalayas one day, he saw a wonderful city with 9 gates, which he understood to have all good qualities. Puram Lakshita Lakshanai. This place has all the good qualities, such as giving enjoyment to him in fullest extent and also providing him a facility to go back home back to Godhead. This is allegorical story, but the intended meaning of this story is a living entity, a jiva, in search of his happiness, it goes from one species to other species, changing its body, which is compared to the city or township. But having entered into all the species of forms, he was not satisfied with the enjoyment awarded in that particular species. But only when on the southern side of the Himalayas, within Bharata-varsha, when he sees human body, he understood that this human body, which is made up of 9 gates, the 9 holes, are basically the 2 ears, 2 eyes, 2 nostrils, and one mouth, the genital and rectum. So these are the 9 holes of the body. He understood this particular township, this particular body of human species with 9 holes, is embedded with all the good qualities, wherein he get complete enjoyment, and also by practicing bhakti can go back home back to Godhead. That is also another reference about this particular place, which is called as Bharata-varsha. There is another reference from 7th canto Bhagavatam, wherein Prahlad Maharaj teaching to his friends, Kaumara Charet Prajno Dharman Bhagavatan Hya Durlabham Manusham Janma Tadapi Adruva Martadam. The wise person should practice bhakti yoga in his life from youth, that is Kaumara. Human birth is rare and transient but effective for practicing bhakti. Thus, at the age of Kaumara, that is 1 to 5 years itself, one should practice Bhagavad Dharma, which includes hearing and chanting, having taken birth in the land of Bharata-varsha, which is very difficult to get birth here and which is very limited and which is suitable for practicing bhakti. Thus, one should not waste his life in Bharata-varsha. These are some of the supporting references about the glories of Bharata-varsha. And finally, let us refer to a Sankalpa mantra, which is generally chanted at the beginning of any auspicious ceremony in our household ceremonies. This mantra is basically indicates that the owner of the house is now making a oath in front of all the devatas and all the sages, all the assembled guests, that at this point of time, at this place, I am going to undertake this particular task of performing so and so samskara for the benefit of me, my family members and my ancestors, etc., etc., etc. So this Sankalpa mantra which is presented here is for Makar Sankranti of 2017, which is on 14th January. So it goes like this. Sri Govinda 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 Asya Sri Bhagavata Mahapurushasya Vishnur Ajnaya Pravartamanasya. As an order of Lord Vishnu, I am going to undertake this particular samskara ceremony. So it says that Adya Brahmana, from the year of Brahma's birth, Dvitiya Parardhe, in the second half, that is 51st year of Lord Brahma. 50 years of Lord Brahma already passed. The 51st year, first month, first day is currently running. So it is referring to the second part of Brahma's life. In that, Sri Shweta Varaha Kalpe, the very first day of Brahma's first month in the second half is called Shweta Varaha Kalpa, since Lord Varaha appeared in the white color at the beginning of this day of Brahma. Within that Shweta Varaha Kalpa, there are 14 manvantaras, out of which 6 manvantaras are already passed. Now 7th manvantara is running. That's why it is called Vaivashvata Manvantare. In the reigning period of the current Manu Vaivashvata, the 7th Manu period. Within that 7th manvantara period, which is lasting for 71 Divyayugas, 27 Divyayugas already passed. Now the 28th Divyayuga or Mahayuga is running. Ashta Vimshati Tame, in the 28th Mahayuga of the manvantara. Kali Yuga Pratama Pade, in the 28th Mahayuga, Satya Treta Dwapara already completed. Now Kali Yuga is running. Within that Kali Yuga, which lasts for 432,000 years, the very Pratama Pada, first quarter, is running. Only we have completed 5,120 years out of 432,000 years. So this is Kali Yuga Pratama Pade. This is indicating the time stamp with respect to the birth of Lord Brahma. Then about the place. Within the Bhumandala, The seven islands were created by Parivartha Maharaj. The centermost island is Jambu-dvipa. In Jambu-dvipa, the centermost island of the Bhumandala. Bharata-varsha. The Jambu-dvipa further divided into 9 varshas, out of which the southernmost tract of land is called Bharata-varsha. That Bharata-varsha is further divided into 9 islands. The southernmost island is Bharatakanda, thus Bharatakande, in the 9th division of Bharata-varsha. And this Bharata-varsha and Bharatakanda were situated on the southern side of Mount Meru. So Meru ho Dakshina Parshve, Godavari Dakshina Tire. In that 9th tract of island, which is known as Bharatakanda, our place is situated on the southern side of Godavari River, the land on the south side of Godavari River. And then Sayadri Kshetra Samipe, at the foot of Sayadri mountain range. Mama Swagruhe, the owner is saying that my house is located in this area, at the southern side of Godavari River and near to the foothills of Sayadri mountain. In my home, Devata Sanidav, in the presence of my household deities, I am going to undertake this so and so samskara. Let all the devatas, all the sages, all the assembled guests be witness to this particular samskara. Then, with respect to the timestamp from the first quarter of Kali Yuga, Asmin Vartamana Vyavaharike, in the current period now reigning, the first quarter of Kali Yuga, Prabhavadi Shishti Samvatsarana Madde, among the 60 years starting from Prabhava Samvatsara, Dhurmukha Nama Samvatsare, Dakshinayane, that year from the Gudipadava of 2016 to Gudipadava of 2017 is called Dhurmukha Nama Samvatsara, and we are specifically referring to the January 14th of 2017. So that time it was Dakshinayane. Dakshinayana will be there up to morning 7:50 a.m. on that particular day. At 7:51 a.m. Uttarayana will begin. So Hemanta Rutau Chandramane, it is Hemanta Rutu, it is winter season. According to Chandramana, if you take calculations according to Chandramana, it is Pushamase. That Pushamasa started on 13th December, it will last till say 27 January. And according to Sauramana, it is Dhanurmasa. Dhanurmasa started on 16th December, which will continue to last till 14th January. And according to Chandramana, it is Krishna Paksha. It is dark fortnight after the full moon day. So then, Dvitiya Shubatitav. This is in the Krishna Paksha, that is second Tithi, which is Dvitiya. Shani Vasara, that day it was Saturday. Ashlesha Nakshatra. According to Chandramana, the moon is traveling in Ashlesha Nakshatra. According to Suryamana, the sun is traveling in Uttarashada Nakshatra. So thus it is indicated exactly to the point of time where the sun moon are located in the space, what was the day, what was the Tithi, what was the Paksha, what was the month, what was the season, what was the year, everything is pointed out to say that at what place, at what point of time, so and so person is undertaking so and so ceremony. Sri Vishnu Yoga Sri Vishnu Karana Shubha Yoga Shubha Karana Esham Guna Visheshana Vishishtayam Asyam Dvadashyam Shubha Sitav Sri Bhagavat Agnaya Sri Bhagavat Kainkarya Rupam. As Bhagavat Agna, as Bhagavat Kainkarya, I am undertaking this particular task of performing this ceremony for the pleasure of the Supreme Lord, for the purification of our existence. Thus the Sankalpa Mantra also gives the description of the Bhumandala, its divisions as 7 islands, among which Jambu-dvipa, its division as 9 varshas, among which Bharata-varsha, its divisions as 9 dvipas, among which Bharatakanda. In that Bharatakanda, referring to different mountains and different rivers, ultimately points to the place where we are living. Thus, this is what we have discussed till now, indicating the summary of entire discussion. This is Jambu-dvipa surrounded by salt water ocean, surrounded by second island, third island, etc. Within Jambu-dvipa there is Mount Meru, on top of which there are townships of 8 devatas surrounded by the city of Lord Brahma. And at the base, the Jambu-dvipa is divided into 9 divisions by boundary mountains. These are the divisions, the 9 divisions of Jambu-dvipa, which are known as 9 varshas. And specifically Bharata-varsha is further divided into 9 divisions, which are known as 9 dvipas. Among which the bottommost and the southernmost is Bharata-varsha. And how Ganga descends from the causal ocean, enters into the universe and flows throughout the Jambu-dvipa and enters into salt water ocean, etc. So everything has been discussed till now is presented in this slide. people who read through this Vedic literature have drawn so many images attributing them to a globe spherical structure. So here you see, this is all Jambu-dvipa, and they're surrounded by Lavana Samudra. This is Plakshadvipa, Ikshu Samudra, and Shalmali Dvipa, etc. It goes down, and within Jambu-dvipa the different divisions of all the varshas are shown here. Hari Varsha, Kimpurusha Varsha, and then Bharata Varsha, everything is shown here. Different places within the Bharata Varsha. This is the path of Ganga is shown here. This is Sagara Mela. And some other people draw a map like this, wherein Mount Meru is here, Nishadha Mountain, Hari Varsha, Maha Himavan Mountain, Himavat region, Lagu Himavat region, and Bharata region, etc. etc. These are all Jambu-dvipa, and this is Lavana Samudra, second dvipa, second samudra, third dvipa, third samudra, etc. etc. They describe. And some people consider this particular area within the world map to be Jambu-dvipa, wherein this is Ilavurta Varsha, Mount Meru is here, Hari Varsha, Kimpurusha Varsha, Bharata Varsha is considered to be the land of India, etc. Thus, different people come up with different understandings, etc. Here, some people describe that the entire Earth globe, the world map to be the entire Bharata Varsha, wherein the path of Ganga is shown here through India, etc. So, nowadays, some people consider this entire Earth globe to be the flat earth, wherein everything can be depicted like this. The sun travels and moon travels in the same orbital distance, wherein sun travels, this enlighten this particular area giving day, the remaining area is dark, etc. etc. This is how the explanations are talked about the flat earth model. The Antarctic area is considered to be the wall around the entire earth world map. So these are another images about the flat earth concepts. So this is how people consider about the earth globe, which is how it is situated. This is how the aerial ships traveling, and this is how the moon planet is there and sun planet is there, because of which we get light, stars are there in the sky. These are the various descriptions about Jambu-dvipa. Thus we have covered till now chapter 16 to chapter 19, detailed description of different divisions, their nature, people, their activities of this entire Jambu-dvipa. Thank you very much. In the next presentation, we will discuss about the remaining